incoming students, myself Sanjay Kumar Tiwari, welcoming you to e-learning platform of St. Michael Higher Secondary. Students, I have been uploading different videos related to your language and literature and hope that you are going through them, you are getting benefits of all the videos that have been uploaded. Now, students, today I have decided to teach you to start a new chapter, that is active and passive voice. Dear students, the chapter that I have decided to start is very important. It is so important that without this we cannot be perfect in speaking, reading or writing skill. Students, this chapter is directly related to transitive verb. It's very much important that there are two ways of expressing an action. Action means verb by using a transitive verb. One fact, the way of expression is two. It means any statement, if it has a transitive verb, I would like to make the meaning clear. Transitive verb means a verb with an object, a verb that needs an object to complete its meaning. So, if there is a sentence, there is any activity, any action, and it is followed by any transitive verb, that action, that activity is expressed through transitive verb. There are two important ways of expressing an action by using a transitive verb. These two ways are known as the active and second one is passive voice. Active voice and passive voice. Here is one sentence. Albert wrote a letter. Albert wrote a letter means Albert is subject, wrote is transitive verb, or letter is an object. You have to keep in mind. And the same sentence has been written in a different way without any change in meaning. A letter was written by Albert. Two ways of expression, same meaning. Meaning has not been changed. So the first sentence is there in active mood, the second one is in passive mood. These two sentences have the same meaning. They are simply two different ways of saying the same thing, which are known as active voice and passive voice. In sentence first, the subject Albert is the doer of an action. He is doing the action himself. Therefore, the verb wrote is said to be in active voice, active mood. What happens in second one? In sentence second, the subject, a letter, is the receiver of action. Here you find a letter has been written or placed in place of subject. Albert has been replaced by a letter. And this letter has been replaced by Albert. In other ways, we can simply say that subject has become an object and an object of active voice has become the subject. The difference that is generated or created is that in the first sentence, Albert is the subject, he himself wrote a letter. It means the way, the task of writing the letter was done by Albert. In the second one, this letter becomes receiver. That has been made clear. The subject, a letter in the second sentence, is the receiver of an action. That is why it is said to be in the passive voice. So, you may conclude after going through these two sentences that a transitive verb may be used in active voice as well as in passive voice. A verb is said to be in active voice when the subject acts or performs the action. That I have already stated, subject should be the doer, performer of the action. certain more sentences are here. Mohan killed a snake. Neha sings a song. Sohan is writing a letter. If you look at these examples and these sentences, you will find that the objects of all these three sentences are a snake, a song, and a letter respectively. The verb used in the sentences are killed, sings, is writing. So, a verb is said to be in passive voice only when the subject of the verb is acted upon or receives the action. It is said to be in passive voice. What happens in active voice? The subject himself is the performer, is the doer of the action. All these sentences have been written in passive mood here. A snake was killed by Mohan. A song is sung by Neha. A letter is being written by Sohan. So, please keep it in mind that the way of expression of any statement, any action by using a transitive verb has got two ways. They are known as active voice when the subject is doer, passive voice when the subject is receiver of the action. So, please keep it in mind that these two forms of voice, active and passive, are going to depend upon the way of performance, the way of expressing an action by using a transitive verb. Students, now here is a newspaper report of a young girl who went back in time to see how her home down log 75 years ago. Dehra Times is the name of the newspaper where a report of a young girl who described, who went back in time to see how her hometown looked 75 years ago. She goes back in the past tense. You will be surprised to know report, you will be familiar, or if not familiar, it will be taught to you in due course of time. Purkul, 7 July 1999, it is reported that Karina, a 12-year-old girl living in Purkul, went back in times using a time machine. 75 years ago, her hometown was an ideal place to live in. Her hometown had not been invaded by the marvels of technology. Industries had not been set up since then, so the air was not polluted. She could see children playing in the garden. Some children were listening to the stories told by their grandmothers. Happiness and contentment prevailed everywhere. If you go through this report, you will find that most of the sentences have been written in passive tone, passive mood. So, passive voice is also wanted or demanded whenever we have to write something. And you will be surprised to know that active voice can only be a way of expression. It is not sufficient, it is not enough, and with the help of it, we cannot complete our required writing or speaking skill. So, passive voice is needed. Now, you have come to know that a passive construction does two things. It brings the object to the position of the subject. It introduces the verb to be and the past participle form of the verb. It is made clear that you have to use past participle in passive voice, whatever forms of verb has been used in that. Students, rest of the ways, rest of the things related to this important chapter will be taught to you next video. Thank you.